Once we have a handle on multiplying and dividing rational expressions, we are then ready to move on to adding and subtracting them. Before we do this with variables, let's brush up on adding numeric fractions. Remember that adding fractions does not work like multiplication. You can't just go straight across to get your result. You have to have a common denominator. So let's see if we can figure out what it will be in this case. With numbers, you can find a common denominator by simply multiplying the two denominators. However, that's a little bit inefficient. We can do a little bit better if we make a factor tree for each denominator and then figure out what things they need to have in common. So let's start with 48. We'll make our factor tree for 48. 48 is 4 times 12. 4 is 2 times 2. And 12 is 3 times 4, and 4 is again 2 times 2. Now let's do the same thing with 36. 36 is 6 times 6. 6 is 2 times 3. And the other 6 is also 2 times 3. So we've determined that 48 is 4 2's multiplied by 1 3. In other words, it is 2 to the 4th power times 3. 36, on the other hand, has 2 2's multiplied by 2 3's, so it is 2 to the 2nd times 3 to the 2nd. This gives us the tools to build our common denominator. The common denominator has to have each of the individual elements that we see, 2's and 3's. So we know it's going to have some 2's and it's going to have some 3's. In terms of how many of each we need the highest of each power that appears between the two fractions. So for the 2's, we have 4 here and we have 2 here, which means that we're going to have 4 2's in our common denominator. For the 3's, we have 1 3 here and 2 3's here, which means we will need 2 3's in our common denominator. Multiplying out 2 to the 4th times 3 squared gives us 144. That's going to be our common denominator. Now let's see if we can finish out the problem. We need to rewrite our fractions with 144 as our denominator. So, let's see, 13 over 48 plus 7 over 36. We have to turn the 48 into a 144. Well, we can do that by multiplying it by 3. But if we're going to do that to the bottom, we have to also do that to the top of the fraction. Similarly, with the 36, we can turn that into 144 by multiplying it by 4. But again, whatever we do to the bottom of the fraction, we have to do to the top. Multiplication we know how to do straight across in each case. And what we end up with is 3 times 13 is 39 on the top and 144 on the bottom. For the second fraction, 7 times 4 is 28 on the top and again 144 on the bottom. Now that we have our common denominator, 144 here, 144 here, we are in a position to add. We add the numerators together. 39 plus 28 is 67. And the denominator doesn't change, 144. When adding fractions that involve variables, the most important and sometimes most difficult step is identifying the least common denominator between the two fractions. We can follow the same process that we did with numeric fractions of identifying the factors of each denominator and figuring out how many of each we need. Looking at this first example, we see x minus 1's in the bottom of both fractions, and we see x plus 2's in the bottom of both fractions. This tells us that our LCD is going to be composed of x minus 1's and x plus 2's. Now that we have the basic building blocks, we need to determine how many of each of these factors we need. And to do that, we look back to the original fractions up here. And the rule to follow is that we need the highest power that appears in any individual fraction for a given factor. For instance, looking at the x minus 1, so we have x minus 1 to the third in one of our fractions, and x minus 1 squared in another. We take the highest power of these, 3, that's what is going to go into our common denominator. Same idea for the x plus 2. We have 1x plus 2 in this fraction, and 4x plus 2s in this fraction, which means that overall we need 4x plus 2s, and that is our common denominator between these two expressions. For our second example, we're going to use the same strategy. However, notice that our denominators are not factored like they were with the first example. And so we need to start by factoring. A squared minus 4a minus 4 factors into a minus 2 times a minus 2. And a squared minus 3a plus 2 factors into a minus 2 times a minus 1. Now, for our purposes, it's going to be a little easier to view a minus 2 times a minus 2 as a minus 2 squared. Now that everything is factored, we're in a position to put together the common denominator. So our common denominator in this case is going to be composed of a minus 2s, because we have some of those, and we also have an a minus 1, so that needs to be part of it as well. So a minus 2, a minus 1. And now we have to determine how many of each we need. For the a minus 2s, we have 2 in one fraction and 1 in another, and so we only need 2. For the a minus 1, well, there's only one a minus 1 in the whole problem, and so we only need 1 in our common denominator. So there's our LCD. Now, finally, it's time for us to add two rational expressions. Our first goal is going to be to identify the least common denominator between the two expressions, and then our second goal will be to get that common denominator on the bottom of both and then add. First, we need to factor everything. In this case, x squared minus 9 factors into x minus 3 times x plus 3, and x squared minus 6x plus 9 factors into x minus 3 squared. Now we can identify the least common denominator. The LCD in this case is going to have to contain x minus 3s, and it's going to have to contain x plus 3s, and we will need just one x plus 3 because there's only one in the whole problem. We have two x minus 3s here and one x minus 3 here, so overall we need 2 for our common denominator. Now that we've identified our common denominator, the next task is to get that on the bottom of both of our fractions. So let's rewrite our expressions with the factored denominators. And for each one, we need to identify what pieces of the LCD do we already have and what pieces are we missing. So looking at the first fraction, we see our denominator is x minus 3, x plus 3. Our common denominator has two x minus 3s, and so we are missing 1 in this first fraction. So we're going to insert 1 to fill in the gap. But whatever we do to the bottom of the fraction, we need to do to the top. Same idea for the second fraction. We have two x minus 3s already. For our LCD, we need those two x minus 3s, and we also need an x plus 3. So we'll stick one in. But again, whatever we do to the bottom, we have to do to the top. Now we need to multiply. On the top of the first fraction, we have x times x minus 3. If we distribute, that gives us x squared minus 3x. On the bottom, we will have our LCD. X minus 3 squared, x plus 3. For the second fraction, same process. We're going to multiply 4 times x plus 3 for the numerator. That will give us 4x plus 12. And on the denominator, we'll have our LCD, x minus 3 squared, x plus 3. Now, finally, we have the same denominator on both of our fractions, and so we can add the numerators together. That will be our last step. So when we add x squared minus 3x plus 4x plus 12, The x squared and the 12 don't have any like terms, but we do have a minus 3x and a positive 4x that can combine. X squared plus x plus 12 over the LCD. X minus 3 squared, x plus 3. And there's our final result.